All right, guys, as you can see, we've got the boat finally completed here, and it's all made once again out of that foam board. And you may have noticed Jordan has actually added some flames to the side of it just to make it a little more interesting, and those are just made out of duct tape. And we actually added duct tape to the entire sides and underside of the boat just to make it more waterproof. And then he also took a piece of that duct tape and made a little windshield as well. And inside, you can see it has the wood deck that we put in there. And we also made this cab so that it just pulls off. And that way you can get to the candles and switch those out and light them and all that kind of stuff. And as you can see, our steam engine's all fixed the way it should be. And the tubing just comes out the back through that transom, just like a through-hole exhaust on a speedboat. And you'll notice we've actually put RamblinAround across the back as well. And anyway, and on the cab here, I just wrapped some aluminum foil around those side braces just because that's where the flame's going to be, and hopefully it'll keep the flames from melting the foam. And right now the weather's not the greatest outside, so instead of putting it in the pond, we're just going to do it in this tub here, and we'll be able to see it really well in this light and see how the steam engine works. Okay, one thing I didn't mention is actually to get this all primed up and ready to go, you actually have to get these tubes full of water. So what I'm going to do is actually just, I've got a container of water here, and I'm going to dip one side in the container, and then I'm just going to suck through this like a straw, which will fill the tubes, and then I'll hold the end shut and set it in the water, and then we'll get the candles and get that going. So let me get this started, and then we'll be right back. Alright guys, like I said, I just put one end in that little cup of water. I sucked it through until it was full, and then now I just tilted it up so it won't come out. And then what I'm going to do is actually just set it down in the water, and then once these are submerged, that water will stay in there. Okay, and we're going to find out right now if this thing even floats. And I'm just going to hold my fingers over it until I get it in the water, and we'll see if it even floats correctly. Actually, that's sitting really nice so far. Okay. So now the tubes are full of water. Now we've got our little power plant here, our two candles, and I'm just gonna light these up and set them under the coils. And it's probably gonna take a while to heat those up because, like I said, these coils are a little bigger than I wanted to use. And we're just gonna set them. See, those flames are right under that tubing, okay? So I'm hoping it won't take very long to get it to boil up. Heating the tubing up. Now, it's all the way against the back wall, and if we don't touch it, it should sit motionless. And the only way it's going to move forward is if that steam power actually works. So we'll just kind of watch it and see what happens. Because there's nothing else that'll drive it. It looks like it's moving.
I think it's going.
It's actually pumping forward, I believe. I can see the boat pulsing, like it's wanting to move. It may just not have enough propulsion. Oh, there it goes. Look, here it goes. Sweet! See the pulse? That's awesome. It's starting to pump. It's working really well. Look at that. It's starting to, it's like any steam engine. It's going to take a little time to get heated up where it's really going to get the cycle going. Let me back it up, and we'll, as it goes again, I'll explain to you how this is actually working again. Okay, so as those flames in there are heating up the coils, it's causing that water to become steam. And what that steam does is it pushes the rest of the water out of these tubes and out the back of the boat, which propels it forward, okay? But the cool thing is, as it propels that water out, the steam that's coming through the tubes actually cools off and recondenses, okay? Or, well, not recondenses, but condenses. And then when it does that, it creates a vacuum which sucks more water up into the tubing, and then the whole process just starts over, and it runs in a series of pulses. Yeah, we're starting to get the coils heated up pretty well now, which is actually increasing the speed by quite a bit. As you can see, it's moving along pretty well. I think this is pretty good for a preliminary test. We're definitely going to take it out in the pond on another day when we get some nice weather, and we'll just see how fast it can chug along. Because it'll actually continue to build speed as it crosses a big body of water. We're just not allowing it to really get pumping here. But as you can see, I mean, it's driving itself completely under its own power, so it's pretty neat. And we actually built this boat a little too heavy just because we got a little carried away. See it actually pulsing the water out the back? All right. Well, anyway, guys, hopefully you found that interesting. And like I said, we'll get it out for a little better test on another day. Thanks for watching and commenting and everything. And I'll see you later. Bye.